Welcome to our special talk on agripreneurship-led extension. Our great nation is poised to celebrate 75th year of independence as Azadi Ka Amrit Mahotsav. It's a proud moment for all of us. ICR National Rice Research Institute, Cuttack, is celebrating Azadi Ka Amrit Mahotsav. NRRI has planned several special talks during next 1 year in the run-up to completion of 75 years of our independence. That will culminate on 15th August 2022. This is the first talk in the series. On this occasion, we are proud to have with us Dr. P. Chandrasekara, Director General, National Institute of Agricultural Extension Management, Manage, Hyderabad. I request our Honorable Director, Dr. Deepankar Maiti, to welcome our honorable special guest, Dr. P. Chandrasekara, and other dignitaries to the virtual function. Dr. Maiti, sir, please.
Thank you, Dr. Mandal. So a very good evening and warm welcome to one and all to today's lecture session on agripreneurship-led agricultural extension as a part of lecture series celebrating the nation's Azadi Ka Amrit Mahotsav. First of all, I, on behalf of National Rice Research Institute and my own behalf, extend our hearty welcome to respected Dr. P. Chandrasekara, Honorable Director General, National Institute of Agricultural Extension Management, known as MANAGE in Hyderabad, and today's speaker. I cordially welcome the August gathering on this virtual platform, Honorable Vice Chancellors, senior officials from ICR headquarters and universities, directors of institutions, scientists, faculties of several universities, my colleagues of National Rice Research Institute and other institutions, ladies and gentlemen. As we commence year-long celebration of our 75 years of independence, coined as Azadi Ka Amrit Mahotsav, we fondly rejoice the impressive post-independence journey of Indian agriculture that made us a food surplus country. The production of food grains, fruits, vegetables, milk, meat, egg, and fish has increased significantly. Concerted research programs since our independence have led to development of new technologies that made India a vibrant agricultural economy. National agricultural research education and extension system plays a crucial role in dissemination of agricultural technologies among farmers by using inter alia digital platforms for communication. However, still there exists gaps in transfer of technology or information from lab to land. Agripreneurship-led extension may fill the void in the days to come. Thus, today's talk, agripreneurship-led extension, has been organized, and let us enjoy the moment. It will be my great honor and proud privilege to listen to Dr. P. Chandrasekara, an eminent scientist and administrator in the field of agriculture. Dr. P. Chandrasekara's area of expertise are agricultural extension and management, agri-entrepreneurship development, agricultural marketing management, and public partnership. As we understand, entrepreneurship is basically a concept that encompasses transforming an idea or vision into a new business or new venture creation or the expansion of an existing business by an individual, a team of individuals, or established businesses. But entrepreneurship, as opposed to self-employment, is also defined as the spirit of the entrepreneurs. So entrepreneurs are usually creative, take opportunities and accept risks, and can quickly change business strategies to adapt changing environments. They're often innovators too. And as we know, agripreneurship refers to the entrepreneurship in agriculture. And let us now move ahead with today's proceedings and listen to Dr. P. Chandrasekara to educate ourselves on this issue. Before that, I request Dr. P.C. Rath Head Crop Protection Division of NRI to place formal introduction to our today's esteemed speaker. I once again welcome you all to this lecture session. Thank you very much.
Thank you for giving me opportunity to introduce the guest speaker, Dr. P. Chandrasekhar, Director General Manage, Hyderabad, on the occasion of a first lecture in the lecture series of Azad Ka Amrit Mahotsav, celebration of 75th years of independence at ICR NRI Cuttack. Dr. Chandrasekhar is a leading personality of India. Many of the senior colleagues might have known him, and this small introduction about him is to refresh the knowledge to the audience. Dr. Chandrasekhar is a leading professional in the field of agriculture with 31 years of experience and expertise in the areas, namely agricultural extension management, agri-entrepreneurship development, agricultural marketing management, and a public-private partnership. During more than 3 decades of service, he headed 3 premier agricultural institutions in the India, coming under Minister of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare, Government of India. He served as a Director General in charge of National Institute of Plant Health Management and a Director General of CCS, National Institute of Agriculture Marketing, and currently serving as a Director General of National Institute of Agriculture Extension Management. His outstanding biodata includes many of which few I will point out here. Dr. Chandrasekhar published 87 technical papers, 24 books, and 9 films. He organized 610 national and international level training programs. He is having many awards to his credit. Few of them are Young Scientist Award 2007 by Indian Society of Extension Education, Magnum National Honor Award 2011 by Magnum Foundation Nagpur, Dr. D.K. Memorial Award 2015 by Indian Society of Extension Education, Dewang Mehta Education Leadership Award 2019, Lifetime Achievement Award 2019 from SRDA in Agriculture Extension, Lifetime Achievement Award 2019 for driving entrepreneurship movement in India by NITTE Karnataka Bank Limited. He is honored with the Award of Excellence during International Conference on Doubling of Farmers' Income of SAARC countries held at Kathmandu by International Society of Extension Education. Dr. Chandrasekhar served as a jury during EM Summit SMA competition 2021. He is an advisor, Bio-Imports Producers Association, BIPA India, executive editor of Manage Journal of Agriculture Extension Manage, and editor of Manage International e-Bulletin. Dr. Chandrasekhar initiated e-Bulletin Agripreneur and a voice of CCS NIAM and chairperson of e-Bulletin Farm to Fork. He holds vice presidents of International Society of Extension Education. He guides many institutions. One such is an expert member to evaluate the performance of a coffee board and the State Agricultural University of Karnataka. Sir, we are proud to have Dr. Chandrasekhar to deliver first lecture in the lecture series of Azad Ka Amrit Mahotsav celebration of 75 years of India's independence at National Rice Research Institute, Cuttack. I thank one and all for giving me opportunity. Thank you.
To everyone present in this program. Thank you, Dr. Mandal. Thank you, Dr. Rath, for kind words. Thank you, Dr. Maithi, Director, for this invitation. I'm seeing a large number of my colleagues who are present in this talk series. Hello to everyone. On this occasion, I would like to congratulate again every one of you on the joyful occasion of year-long celebration of 75th independence year of our motherland. Independence is not mere political independence. After 75 years, we realize that 17.7 million of our population are without homes. More than 70% of the females and more than 50% of the males, they are suffering from one or the other diseases. Around 50% of the population, they don't have access to safe drinking water. Still, 25% of the population are illiterates, and more than 22.5% of our population, they live below poverty line. See, after 75 years, we have another Herculean task to manage, to address all these serious problems. But coming back to agriculture, one of the greatest achievement made by you all scientists, thanks to extension workers and policy makers, and most importantly, the farmers in this country, is to make our motherland self-sufficient in food production. Today we have, you know, we are producing 303 million tons, at least 100 million tons our reserve food is available in Food Corporation of India. Nothing to worry about the food. But the issue is different. We are shifting our focus from food security to nutritional security. So because I have given the data, nutrition plays very important role in the healthy growth of a nation. So since these issues are there, we are shifting our focus from food security to nutritional security and ultimately income security of the farmers. Why income security of the farmers? Today, if you ask any farmer, one of the surveys says more than 76% of the farmers, if any alternative option is available, they would like to quit agriculture. It's a very serious concern for all of us, scientists, extension workers who are working for the development of agriculture. The reason is more than 50 to 60% of the producer share in consumer rupee is going to the intermediaries. You know, the local traders, the wholesale traders, the retailers, and many more middlemen in the channel. The money is going to them, not to the producer. So as a result of that, the farmer income is not enhanced and they're not seeing prosperity and profitability in agriculture. That is the reason why majority of the people, they want to quit agriculture, especially the younger generation, sons and daughters of the farmers, educated or uneducated. They want to quit villages, go to urban areas. They prefer to sit as a watchman or a lowly paid labor rather than cultivating the land. That is where the agripreneurship come into picture. What is agripreneurship? This particular word we introduced during 2002 when we started Agri Clinic and Agri Business Center scheme, because we need to have a special place for the entrepreneurs in agriculture. So we coined a word called agripreneurs. I'm very happy that now throughout the world, this term is being circulated, creating a special place for entrepreneurs in agriculture. So this agripreneurs, what we are talking is blending entrepreneurship with agriculture, and agripreneurship led extension is focusing agripreneurship in extension activities. Let's start with, when we talk about agripreneurship led extension, it is not independent. It is not independent extension activity. It relates to agriculture education. It relates to agricultural research on the other hand. So, but if you focus on extension, earlier, all the extension programs were designed to address the deficit, but today we have surplus. So we need to, when agriculture is changing, we need to change agricultural extension also. So apart from traditional, example, the definition of agricultural extension, probably we have to we see a lot of meaning in the definition of agricultural extension set by Doubling Farmers Income Committee of 2018. This committee redefined agricultural extension as an empowering system. It is not mere one-time activity of transfer of technology. It is empowering system of sharing information, knowledge, technology, skill, risk, and farm management practices across agricultural subsectors. It's not only agriculture, horticulture, animal husbandry, fisheries, all along the agriculture value chain. This is very, very important. It is not production-led extension. It addresses the post-harvest issues also, so as to enable the farmers to realize higher net income from the enterprise on a sustainable basis. It is not for one season, one crop in 1 acre, but it is for all the time to come. They have to get higher net income from agriculture, treating it as an enterprise. So these are all the qualitative changes we see in the way we look at agriculture. We see this as a agri enterprise, and to lead this agri enterprise, we need agripreneurs. So whatever the extension we undertake, we need to shift our focus from addressing the farmers to treating them as agripreneurs. So that is the reason why agripreneurship-led extension is need of the hour. So if we go to field, you know, farmers are asking different questions, which are not traditionally nature. Now, traditionally, we discuss with the soil management, water management, weed management, pest and disease. But if you go to farmer today, they ask about, you know, with the same piece of land, same crop, how we can get more production, productivity, profitability. With the same piece of land, how I can grow more number of crops so that the income will increase. What are the government, state government and central government programs one can take benefit? What is the market-oriented information which is required for the farmers? For example, which is the nearest market? What is the price of the commodity? And farmers' exposure to social media, mass media, their aspirations are also increasing. How to manage these aspirations? And many people from urban areas, highly qualified people, they want to put money in agriculture, capital-intensive agriculture. These are all the today's and tomorrow's requirement in extension, which are not addressed by traditional extension. Therefore, we are talking about agripreneurship-led extension. Now, what kind of changes, qualitative changes, we want to see in extension? One is efficiency of extension should increase. Whatever we want to communicate to farmer, it should be communicated. There should not be communication distortion in between. That is efficiency. We want to increase effectiveness of extension. We want to see some change. When we communicate a technology, farmer has to adopt that. That is the change. This is effectiveness of extension. We want to see the extension is result oriented. Therefore, the effectiveness is important. And it has to be cost effective, because we deal with 130 million farmers. It's very difficult to provide, you know, very costly agricultural extension advisory services all the time to all the farmers addressing all the problems. It has to be cost effective extension. Most important, providing real time extension. You know, if a farmer wants to sell his produce, he wants to know what is the price of a particular commodity in a nearby market on that particular day, real-time extension. What is going to be the weather next day, whether he has to undertake harvesting, whether he has to undertake drying. This real-time information is becoming very, very important, but that is where, you know, extension is struggling. We are struggling to give real-time extension advisory services, which is required by the farmers. Location-specific extension. Very generic package of practices which are prepared at state level may not be suitable to a particular district, particular block, particular village. Location-specific extension advisory services are need at the hour. Integrated and inclusive extension, agriculture value chain extension. Here, extension services are not provided only to the farmers, even to traders, even to service providers, even to consumers. So extension for risk management, extension for sustainability, health and nutrition, which is focus of today, and capacity building of large number of extension functionaries on the future needs of agricultural extension. So these are all some of the important elements we want to see in the changed extension. Ultimately, you know, all these things starts from the policy. See, Honorable Prime Minister, he talked about Atmanirbhar Bharat and Atmanirbhar Krishi found a very important place. He dealt with four important aspects. Number one, how can we transform farmers into entrepreneurs to increase their income and better quality of life? That is what agripreneurship-led extension talks about. Then how can we increase our agriculture export from $30 billion to $60 billion? Basically, it is not only doubling farmers' income, it is doubling agriculture export. You know, when we want to enhance the exportable agriculture commodity, basically the quality has to be ensured at all stages till it reaches the hands of the consumer. And traceability is also one of the requirements asked by the premium consumers. So this is unheard, actually. It is unknown in our agricultural extension system. So it's when we want to double agriculture export, it has implication on extension. And that is why we are talking about agripreneurship led extension. The farmer himself has to, you know, function like an agripreneur entrepreneur. And even the extension should also focus on agripreneurship-led activities. Then make agriculture the go-to investment opportunity, because it should attract, you know, the investment. So this capital can bring several changes, including infrastructure, especially in agriculture, which is ultimately beneficial to farmers. And building a brand of agriculture produce is also another important thing asked. So once this, you know, broad vision is unveiled, also government also made announcement about farm acts, which brings, you know, revolutionary changes in especially agriculture marketing, because this is one area where the farmer is losing money. If you are talking about doubling farmers' income, we have to integrate farmers in the market-led activities. So therefore, the policies addressed market-related issues. I am sure you're all aware, but quickly I will go through this. This is Farmers Produce Trade and Commerce Act 2020. Basically, it talks about ease of doing agriculture marketing. So what is ease? If we had a lot of restrictions, actually, all the restrictions were removed, so that marketing becomes a free activity which is benefiting the farmer. So if farmer wants to sell in APMC, he is free to sell. But if he get a better price outside, he can sell outside also. So another option is created. All inter-district, interstate restrictions are removed, not only for farmers, but also for traders. And same day or within 3 days, farmers should be paid. No market fee. E-trading platform will be developed, and a quick dispute resolution mechanism was also evolved. So basically, it talks about ease of doing agriculture marketing, which is beneficial to the farmers. Then another Contract Farming Act, which was also announced during the same time. It talks about bringing all the farmers together as a group and linking them to processors and exporters by assuring the quality, quantity, and price through contract farming. So this contract farming is the agreement between group of farmers and the trader or the processor or the exporter, so that the trader is also happy because the quantity is ensured, the quality is ensured, and the price is also ensured. So, but the farmer is also happy because the market is ensured and necessary advisory services are provided in the process. So this is agreement on the crop, but not on the land. I'm just repeating this only to remove the apprehensions in in the minds of many people. So the quality can be impartially assured through some kind of qualified assayers, nearby scientists, and the price is always fixed, the market is always fixed, and no permanent structure can be, you know, developed in the farmer field, so that develop some interest in the land of the farmers. And many value-added services like insurance, input supply, custom hiring. So many activities can be brought in contract farming agreement. So these are all the acts, but in order to implement the act, basically we need to mobilize the farmers. Therefore, government announced another, you know, important scheme, formation and promotion of 10,000 farmers producers organizations. You see, popularizing the acts, popularizing the programs so that farmers are aware, empowered, and take the benefit of the schemes, extension has to be very strong. Therefore, all these agripreneurship-led activities should be passed on to the farmers so that awareness is created and farmers take the benefit. So this, you know, the scheme, everybody, you're all aware. Basically, farmers comes together, they grow a particular very crop, and if possible, they link up with the market, link up with the traders, exporters, processors, middlemen are eliminated, so that the producer share in consumer rupee will increase slowly, and that happens only farmers are together. So overhead cost will come down for primary processing and the logistics part, so that every farmer will increase his income. So in hilly areas, at least 100 farmers should be there. In the plain areas, minimum 300 farmers should be there. They are given a CEO, his salary is met by the government, and taking the managerial skills of that particular CEO, we can also promote farmers producers organization. Manage is also one of the organizations for promoting this farmers producers organization. Another important the scheme announced by Government of India. Now, why I am quoting the acts and the schemes? Because it becomes the responsibility of the extension to create awareness about the acts and motivate farmers to take benefits of these schemes. This is the part and parcel of agripreneurship-led extension. So this also becomes one of the important agenda for dissemination in agriculture extension, agriculture infrastructure fund. So basically, it is a medium to long-term debt finance and post-harvest management infrastructure creation by a group of farmers. So that is the idea. Now, individual entrepreneurs are also encouraged to take up this, apart from cooperative societies. Here, two, three important benefits are there. A farmer or a group can take 2 crore rupees, and a credit guarantee is provided to that. You know, agriculture, a lot of uncertainties are there. If they incur any loss, probably that will be met by the banker. So they need not worry about the failure. That's one part. Second one, 3% interest subvention is created so that farmers, if they take a loan and for 7 years, around 40 to 45 lakh rupees, they can save in the interest itself. And viable projects, model projects are developed by government where farmers can, or organizations can make use of that. See, this is one of the important scheme which can benefit farmers producers organization for linking them to market. So when we talk about agripreneurship-led extension, it's very important to create awareness about beneficial acts and beneficial programs and motivate farmers to take the benefit of the program. That is what effectiveness of extension, what we talked about. So many activities can be undertaken under Agriculture Infrastructure Fund. So I would like to deliberate on few ideas which we can promote through agripreneurship-led extension. See, local production, local consumption, linking local production to local consumption, overhead cost, wastage can be reduced, and profit of the farmer as well as the consumer can be increased. So some ideas just I would like to share. We undertook some of the surveys. This survey we conducted in Tamil Nadu in Tirunelveli district. Can we link local farmers to midday meal program? So I'm showing in two boxes, there is benefit definitely to government and there is definitely benefit to the farmers because they're selling in the same village for linking to midday meals program. So for your information, there are 12 crore children are taking food through midday meals. I don't find a better market than this midday meals program for the farmers than any other market. There are 1 lakh crore is spent every year, and 60% is given by Government of India and 40% by state government. But there is a huge scope for linking farmers to local market by linking them to midday meals program. Probably these are all the models we want to promote in agripreneurship-led extension. See another idea just I would like to share with you. See, large number of marriages are taking place in the country, and there are 1 million marriages. It is estimated 10 lakh marriages every year. Every marriage at an average, 5 lakh rupees is spent, 40% of the expenditure on the food. And we did a survey in Hasan district, Arsikere Taluk in Karnataka state, whether we can link farmers to the function halls. And we could find that farmers, they also make profit by selling red gram, banana, and coconut, green chilies and tomato to function halls. And also function halls also get benefited. So somebody has to bell the cat, somebody has to lead the linkage between the producers and function halls. That is the responsibility of agripreneurship-led extension. Agripreneurship-led extension is not a passive extension where the technology is just communicated to farmers. Here, the farmer production system is linked to local consumption system, some kind of mutually acceptable agreement. So that is what the models I am talking about, local production linking to local consumption systems. So large number of SC, ST, OBC, minority hostels are managed by the state government and Government of India. See, they're all government funded programs. If you link farmers producers organizations to these hostels, large number of students they take, they consume food every day. So it provides a very big market, local market for the farmers. Intermediaries can be eliminated. Logistic issues will not be there. Wastage can be avoided. It creates a win-win situation. So there are 904 universities in this country, and in every university, tens of thousands of students, they stay in the hostel. Can we link the local farmers producers organizations with the hostels, student hostels of all these universities? Probably they create a permanent market. This we try to analyze in Punjab Agricultural University, Ludhiana, and surrounding villages, and found to be a win-win situation for both. So this is about some of the out of the box, but easily accessible, low hanging fruits in agripreneurship-led extension at creating market to farmers. So then another just a model I would like to share with you. See, whenever we want to attract rural youth towards agriculture by training them in agripreneurship development, to motivating them to become self-employment, which is very, very difficult actually. When we analyzed, we found that either we are giving training, or we are giving loans, or we are giving subsidies, or we are giving linking them to some farmers. basically in we are dealing this entire issue of creating self-employment opportunity for rural youth in areas in bits and pieces, not holistically. So we made an attempt in Manage with the Syngenta Foundation in a place called Betul in Madhya Pradesh. We brought sons and daughters of farmers at one place. Manage gave training and Syngenta gave seed money of 30,000 rupees. After 6 months, all the entrepreneurs were linked to IDBI Bank for a loan. And we linked with Pradhan, an NGO, to link with Farmers Producers Organization. And every stages, Smart Step, a consultancy group, they helped these people to, providing a handholding support. So in spite of this consortium approach, seeing the entire process holistically, we could able to get just around 50% of the success rate. You can imagine, if you just give training, just give loan, just give subsidy independently, I don't think, we can create a definite impact. Therefore, when we want to promote agripreneurship in rural areas, this consortium approach is very, very important. That's what I'm on left-hand side, all the important stakeholders, they should be together when we want to promote agripreneurship in this country. So this is what, some of the programs which we conducted on this consortium mode found to be highly successful. Now we tried all the, when we went to rural youth, they told, we are not interested in self-employment. Can you get us some employment in rural areas? See, that is also another approach for promoting, agriculture by retaining this youth while undertaking a small-time paid job in rural areas. They can also continue with this agriculture. The benefit of training directly will go to the profitability in their agriculture. So we tried another model with the PA Foundation. And here, we trained rural youth for 45 days in basic agriculture. And just like, the placement in universities, we brought some agribusiness companies. And the last day of the training program, they got placed in agribusiness companies as promoters. The salary is not more, it is 7,000 to 10,000 rupees. But youth can operate from their home and they promote agriculture products, technologies. They could get a small salary of 10,000 rupees. So that created a win-win situation and retaining youth in agriculture and, within the same village. So this is what the program we started. Then this is the first day of the program, 45 days program. You can see after 45 days when they got placement in some agribusiness companies, how confidently they look like. The capacity building, it can bring qualitative and very transformative changes among this rural youth. Public-private partnership is very, very important in promotion of agripreneurship-led extension. You see, you want seed, we have to deal with seed company. Fertilizer, fertilizer company. You want machineries, agriculture machinery company. We want to sell our produce, we have to deal with local trader and wholesalers and retailers. And for logistics, we have to work with transporters and some other infrastructure like, cold storage or warehouse. They're all handled by private service providers. So in order to promote agripreneurship-led extension, it is very important to work with all the service providers, important stakeholders in agriculture. The farmers cannot be kept in isolation, fed only with technology in the name of increasing production, but increasing the profitability and income of the farmer is also important. That is where public-private partnership in agriculture extension is very important. We tried this in a district called Hoshangabad in Madhya Pradesh, Dhanuka Group of Pesticide and Agriculture Department by facilitation of Manage implemented a very popular model called Hoshangabad model. 18 activities, they shared roles and responsibilities, they signed agreement and ultimately benefiting the farmers. Probably these are all some of the good practices I have comprehended in this model, which we developed out of this public-private partnership. In Manage, we are implementing the agripreneurship promoting programs like AgriClinic and AgriBusiness Center scheme and skill training for rural youth and incubation program where agri startups are also promoted. So around 31,000, 700 agri ventures are established under AgriClinic scheme, and 22,500 rural youth have been trained in skill training for rural youth, and around 300 startups are promoted under Agri Startup Program. So we are implementing the program across the country, and even IRRA Cuttack, if you want to join hands with Manage for implementation of Agri Clinic or implementation of STRY program, most welcome. Other some of the ideas which we are trying here, which can strengthen agripreneurship-led extension, are we created a platform called Seva Manage. See, retired agriculture professionals, again, they will come to mainstream extension, work with Manage. They are also helping us to promote entrepreneurship, agripreneurship by involving in program implementation. So we have created a platform. And through Manage Krishi Gyandeep Knowledge Lecture Series, we are trying to develop leadership in agricultural extension. And National Network of Agriculture Journalists, we brought all the agriculture journalists together, and they are working closely with Manage for dissemination of several technologies. And we have established a mechanism called Manage FPO Academy. It's a public-private partnership platform where many knowledge partners, experienced players in FPO promotion, they are working with Manage for promotion of farmers producers organization. We are working for bringing soldiers. There are 60,000 soldiers are retiring every year. We are trying to bring these retired soldiers back to agriculture. We have announced some best MSc and PhD thesis, so that more and more agripreneurship led extension research is also undertaken. And researchable issues focusing on agripreneurship development, we are just trying to make a list so that that will be passed on to extension department across the country. So we are also developing quality manpower in extension is important. In order to develop that, we are also developing 100 strong national facilitators in Manage. We have instituted Agri Startup Awards, Agripreneurs Awards, and we initiated Agri Startup Idea Bank. This will help any young people in rural area to take up agri startups, and planning to organize Agri Film Festival so that focus will remain on agripreneurship development. And we are trying to attract corporate social responsibility linked funds as investment in agriculture, which is also highlighted in Atmanirbhar Krishi. I will focus on very specific programs which are promoting agripreneurship. So this program, Agri Clinic and Agri Business Center scheme, it is implemented by Manage. So 45 days training is given on agripreneurship development, and 1 year post-training handholding support is also provided. 20 lakh rupees loan, 36 to 44% subsidy is also provided. And around 75,000 people are trained, 31,709 ventures are established. So they're all there in every state, and several varieties of activities. Around 32 categories of activities are undertaken by these agripreneurs. So these are all, some of the activities. And several success stories are there. Just in every success story, I request you to see the third line, how many farmers they are reaching, how many jobs they have created, and what is the turnover. See, there are three important things. When we work for promotion of agripreneurs in extension, through extension, in agricultural extension, we can reach more number of farmers. You see, this single entrepreneur, Samiranjan Bordalai in Assam, he is covering around 10,000 farmers. He created a job for 40 people in local areas. That is another advantage. And people say that there is no money in agriculture. So clearly he showed that, you know, there is money in agriculture. 3 crore rupees turnover, even at the rate of, you know, 15-20% profit, it is around 60 lakh rupees per year he is his income. So Nilesh Vasikar is making films. Akbar Ali is providing ICT linked, aqua advisory services. Sangeeta is promoting organic farming, biopesticides. Sellapannu is promoting soil and water testing, input supply, arranging commodity loans, solar farms. Swaibam Surchendra Singh is promoting Pengba fish. This is a local fish, a costly fish. He is producing fish fingerlings and providing to farmers. See this, when we promote agripreneurship, they lead the change in agriculture. So it's very important to produce agripreneurs through agripreneurship led extension so that more and more agripreneurs can benefit more and more farmers. Vijay Bharat in Jharkhand, through mobile school, he is serving so many farmers. And Kavya Jyoti Bora, this water hyacinth is converted into, you know, handy crafts. Then Gajendra Bammaniya, basically in a dairy animal breeding, he is serving large number of farmers. Chauba Devi, he is a veterinary doctor, also provide day-old chicks and piglets to farmers. Chennakesho Sharma doing contract farming. Subramani is a papaya breeder, and also he is making, you know, seeds and selling to the farmers, promoting. So our duty is to bring qualified, competent professionals as agripreneurs, and they lead the change. That is what is happening in this scheme. Raj Kishore Sinha is integrated farming, promoting and demonstrating. Raju from Karnataka, his turnover is 50 crores. He is basically an agriculture missionary, fabricator, as well as a, you know, trader. So when we see at the end of, you know, this program, farmers' yield increased. There is a definite impact on the yield of the farmers, definite impact on income of the farmers. Most important, they created local employment for 1.9 lakh persons, and they covered large number of farmers, and they brought huge private investment in agriculture. So recently we signed MOU with SBI as well as NABARD so that agripreneurs will get loans and subsidy easily. This is about agri startups. Needless to say, NRI Katak also a regional agribusiness incubator. You all know about you know, different kinds of innovations we are coming, and it's very important to train these agri startups, provide effective handholding in the field. Recently, we launched 10 agri startups in the state of Karnataka in presence of Director Agriculture, Director Horticulture, Director Animal Husbandry, and Vice Chancellor, because these innovators, they have difficulty in acceptability in among farming circle. So we are trying to bridge the gap. So these kinds of handholding services are becoming integral part of agripreneurship led extension. Lastly, just I would like to share actually what is ultimate in agripreneurship led extension. When you involve farm women and they initiate income generating activities, if we create that kind of lady entrepreneurs, agripreneurs in rural areas who generate, along with agriculture, generate additional income to the family around agriculture, I think that is ultimate. That is happening in this Kutumbashri program of Kerala. You can see here this group of women. They take the fallow land, they cultivate, they share the profit with the landowners. They develop nursery, food processing, biopharmacy. They're running buses. You know, they are basically rural enterprises, other enterprises, catering, construction unit. They work They are all trained people for this purpose, but they play important role in rural infrastructure creation. At the same time, they can also add a lot of money to their family income. They're running daycare centers, flour mills, ironing unit, information technology unit for all age groups, for all education groups. We can design income generating activities. Mineral water production, they're running restaurants in urban areas, napkin production unit, painting, paper plate manufacturing, band troops, they're running taxi, cloth bags, weaving, hollow bricks, which is used for house construction in rural areas, catering units. This is very important in, you know, the COVID period. For example, aged people, they cannot go to hospital, but this trained paramedical professional, they come, they check, you know, BP, sugar, and for a nominal fees. So it saves, you know, a lot of money. They're running, you know, fitness centers, street dog catching units. So finally, you know, I just want to conclude. Agripreneurship led extension is very, very important, but it also, you know, other concepts like group led extension, market led extension, ICT led extension, and public private partnership led extension play a very complementary and supplementary role for success of agripreneurship led extension. This is the thing, just I wanted to share my mind in front of this very enlightened audience. I am just in time by 4 o'clock. So if you have any queries, certainly we can have discussion.
Thank you, sir. It's truly amazing, mesmerizing, sir. I'm basically tempted to tell that you are the agripreneur, torchbearer of agripreneurship in India. Many of the ideas you have floated, like Agri Startup Idea Bank, Agri Film Festival, are wonderful things. Sir, we thank you profusely from our heart for this enlightening lecture. Now, I request our audience kindly get engaged in a lively discussion with our esteemed speaker so that we can get our ideas, our questions, our queries clarified from the learned speaker.
I am R.B. Tiwari. I think I am audible.
Yes.
I have raised my hand also. Yes. I am R.B. Tiwari from Indian Institute of Horticulture Research, Bangalore. Sir, basically, my specialization is in the value addition processing of fruits and vegetables. Almost last 30 years, I am in IHR. Here, the issue is that as I am following the Food System Summit and One Health, the sustainability, traditional food, and all those areas. And as 80%, even yesterday also, the Chota Kisan, Bharat Kisan, Prime Minister told, linking small farmers to the big market or international market is the one of the main issue. And as you rightly indicated, the traceability system, which involves a lot of IT tools, a lot of integration from the farm gate to the end, it is going to cost money. Now, who is supposed to pay for this?
So number one, linking small and marginal farmers to export. This is very, you know, big dream actually, but we have to realize the dream. Now, what is the expectation of, you know, premier consumers in export market, the people who import? They talk about quality, they talk about traceability, they talk about very stable supply. So for that, it cannot happen by small individual small and marginal farmers. Basically, social mobilization of small and marginal farmers into farmers producers organizations is very, very important. Only this group, an organized group, organized production, where the quality check is there, then only they can be linked to the export market. When we bring farmers together, it becomes easy to link the group to the credit, link the group to the technology, link to the link group to the, you know, the market. Quality control becomes very easy to handle. For example, Paddy Growers Association, Mango Growers Association, Grape Growers Association. So quality control becomes very easy when the small and marginal farmers are in group. Then common facilitation centers, common processing centers can also be created. That is where we can take the help of Agri Infrastructure Fund. So what I am trying to tell is, you know, just by informing small and marginal farmers or just by promising export market, things will not happen. Lot of hard work is required. What we can do is, instead of straight away thinking about linking farmers to export market, can we explore the possibility of linking farmers to local market through some of the means which I discussed? For example, a group of farmers selling their produce to local hotels, restaurants, hostels, function halls. So they should upgrade their skills. They should try to meet the quality expectation of this local consumers, and slowly we can graduate them into export market. Traceability is concerned. Of course, many startups can also play a very important role, and the premium price, what they get, is the main attraction for every farmer to ensure the traceability issue.
So actually, sir, when I joined in 91-92, I used to teach, telling that the fruits and vegetables are purchased based on the quality and the look variety. But as of now, when the people have become more conscious, the issue is not the visible component, but invisible component. What is the state of pesticide residue? Where it is grown using a gray water or a nice water? Whether it has been handled properly. So all these things requires a trust building, for which this certification, organic farming, traceability, all those things. We have to bring from farmer to consumer a third party who is telling that what exactly you are buying is there is a value for money. So this where the issue is bringing the third party who facilitates this, the farmer and consumer, and both way communication. Between the let me put it like a farm to fork, fork to farm should ultimately evolve, then that is going to be a nice issue.
I fully agree with you, Professor. In fact, initially, we cannot eliminate the middleman who ensures quality, middleman who ensures proper grading, sorting, packing, branding, and selling to export market, because they need a lot of capital, networking, and the skill also. So that is not possible for small and marginals initially. But once the farmers habituate for producing for export market with the help of middleman, then slowly it is very easy to graduate them to the next level. We can eliminate middleman and they can directly deal. For example, Sahyadri Farmers Producers Organization in Nasik, having a membership of around 8,000 farmers, all are small and marginal farmers. And their turnover is around 500 crores. The majority of the things, they're exporting. They follow traceability, all international standards, whatever is required for Europe, they have the information, they train the farmers, and entire commodity specific value chain based extension is provided to farmers, and that is ensured. But this graduation time is very, very important.
Yes, sir. Yeah.
That is the responsibility of agripreneurship-led extension. See, Somebody has to lead the change. So
yes.
I gave some examples. Some startups can lead the change. Some agripreneurs can lead the change. Producing the startup and agripreneurs is the responsibility of we all people.
Yes, sir. Thank you very much.
I wanted to know that we are talking a lot nowadays or FPOs, farmer groups, and when they are coming together, small scale farmers, and they can sell better, they will be better. It will be good for them in input purchase as well as marketing their product. But thing is that they hardly come closer. This is very difficult because you may say that they don't have common sense and the conflicts happens. Even FPOs are formed, they disband afterwards. There is a conflicts and all. This is very important. In some parts you gave Sahyadri and all, some, there are some here and there are some examples.
Exceptions.
Exceptions. But largely whenever anybody is trying, some target is there, people are forming these FPOs in hurry. But later on, what is happening? They disband. We don't see these FPO later on next year and something. Even the cooperatives, dairy cooperatives are doing very well in Gujarat and all. In UP doesn't work. So what is the success mantra for the FPOs? What will make them succeed? That really we have to look into how it can be done. So can you throw some light? What are these key?
Actually, whenever we promote farmers producers organization, we think that launching a scheme is promotion of farmers producers organization, which is not so. It is only a incentive we are creating. Now, what exactly the thing happens when we go for mobilizing a group of farmers? So here, there is a need for, you know, a proper leadership. You have seen very successful groups are led by a good leader among them. They made the group very successful. And this leadership can only ensure, success to this group. And sensitizing all the members regarding the kind of roles and responsibilities, changed roles and responsibilities each one has to undertake, and what is the consequence of that, what is the impact of all these actions on production, productivity and income. So this clarity regarding the business plan which they prepare for every farmer producer organization on a participatory mode, through mutual consultation and presenting this business plan in front of every member and creating a level playing field, a common thinking among all the farmers, all the members, is very, very important. Once they are convinced that by doing XYZ activities, they are going to get the profit, they will follow the leader. Developing leader is another important activity which normally we ignore. We think that, you know, by voting, leaders are developed. By over a period of time, leadership. But training deliberately, leaders in extension, is also very, very important.
Thank you. It's nice. Actually, that what you suggested to supplying to hostels, potatoes and all items. Likewise, midday meal scheme is also very good. It can be connected with, in some states, say supplying one egg to every boy and girl in the school, poultry farmer will be benefited. It will be very good. So thank you for all these very good ideas. I could get actually, I liked it very much because it is very systematic and it has covered all the dimensions of extension. Whatever is there, professionalism and all, it was really very good. Thank you for that. Thank you.
So thank you very much, Dr. Mandal. And very good evening to one and all. Respected Dr. P. Chandrasekhara, Honorable DG, National Institute of Agricultural Extension Management, known as MANAGE, Hyderabad. The August gathering on virtual platform, senior officials from ICAR headquarters, directors of ICAR institutes, scientists, faculties of several universities, my colleagues of National Rice Research Institute and other institutes, ladies and gentlemen. It is really my proud privilege to listen to Dr. P. Chandrasekharan, an eminent scientist and administrator in the field of agricultural extension, and address to you all. As we understood from the elaborate presentation by Dr. P. Chandrasekharan, that concept of agripreneurship refers to sustainable, community-oriented, directly marketed agriculture. And that leads to the actual income to the farmers. This concept has evolved from the traditional extension components, including dissemination of technologies and capacity building, of the targeted stakeholders to market-driven agriculture, market-driven agricultural extension. In fact, under modern concept, any research, extension, or developmental program are market or demand-driven. And basically, market-led extension considers farmers as agripreneurs and enables farmers to get high returns, that is money to money, out of the entire farming enterprises. This also facilitates farmers with diverse baskets of package of practices suitable to local situations or farming systems. Market-led extension establishes its position by helping the farmers realize high returns for the produce, minimize the production costs, and improve the product value of the marketability and marketability. So the market demands in terms of produce for the present and the future needs to be identified for developing feasible, viable agripreneurship plan. And also, we could know from the lecture regarding the some out-of-box ideas, right, like the consortia approach, the holistic approach towards agripreneurship development. It's not only capacity building or giving training or some incentives. It is the holistic approach should be there so that all stakeholders to be gathered, pulled together on a consortium mode, and handholding can be given to the entrepreneurs. So now that our nation has achieved self-sufficiency with exportable surplus for most of the major food crops and commodities, farmers' income have not attained to that extent, which led the government of India to set target doubling farmers' income by 2020. And this is not only the farmers' income, as was elaborated by our honorable speaker. It is the overall, the holistic improvement of the agricultural sector, including attracting the rural youths to the entrepreneurship so that they can be supportive to the agriculture. The concept of agripreneurship has evolved as one of the robust approaches to address this target. And we are amazed to listen to such a thought-provoking deliberation of these burning issues from Dr. P. Chandrasekhara, which has mesmerized the whole audience, as I understand, and has created an environment of knowledge on modern concepts of agripreneurship. So I take this opportunity to thank Dr. P. Chandrasekhara for delivering a wonderful lecture. I firmly believe your lecture will serve as source of knowledge and strategies for our scientists and the staff of this premier institute and other stakeholders. So thank you very much, Dr. P. Chandrasekharan, and thank you all. Thank you very much.